Hello and welcome everyone. I'm Sonali Verma from Technical Marketing Engineering team. In this video, we will discuss the enhanced Dell PowerProtect data domain license activation. Here, we will go through the different methods through which the PowerProtect data domain license activation can be performed. The first method is the manual or traditional license activation. Here, I'll cover each prerequisite and I will walk you through a demonstration. Then we will go over the in-product license activation and its supported OS and platform models. We'll start with the types of license activation. So there are mainly two methods to activate licenses in data domain. The first method is the manual or the traditional approach, where we manually activate and download the license from the Software Licensing Central portal, also known as SLC. You can see the URL on the screen now. Then the license is uploaded to the data domain and applied there. Now let's go over its prerequisites. We need to get some of these details from data domain, such as the system locking ID that can be obtained from the CLI command e-license show. Then we will require a system serial number that can be fetched using the command system show serial NO. The DDoS version can be determined by running the CLI command system show version. We also need to gather the license activation code, also known as LAC. It's provided in the email that comes along with the TLD ID or sales order number. So these are the prerequisites that we would need for a license activation using manual method or the traditional method. Now let's see how the license activation can be done manually in this traditional method. Let's start with our first demonstration. Before we begin applying the license through the traditional method, we need to gather some information from the data domain as prerequisites, as discussed earlier. To do so, we will log into the system using PuTTY and will start running the command. Enter e-license show to have the locking ID detail. Then enter system show serial NO to display the system serial number. Afterwards, to fetch the OS information, we will run system show version command. Now we are ready to start, so we will go to the Software Licensing Central portal through the displayed URL. In the left menu, click on the license activation option. And in the search bar provided here, we will enter the LAC code. You should have received it in the email that includes your serial order number. After we hit enter to search, the available entitlements will be seen to activate. We need to select the license required and then press on start activation process. After that, confirm the company and site details over here and then click on select machine to proceed. For new activation, we require the locking ID. We'll grab that from the data domain. First, we need to add the machine if it's not already existing. For that, we will go to Add New Machine section. Over here, we can see that the system is already existing. Next, we can go and search the system using the locking ID. We can see the system is visible over here. So we'll select that and proceed by clicking Enter Details. On the next screen, under Quantity, click on the Prefill All Available Quantities checkbox to enter the product quantities. Then scroll down to select the OS. To know which OS to enter, we can go back to the data domain where we can see it's 8.0 OS. So we'll come back to SLC and select 7.12 and above and click on Next Review option. Here, after reviewing all the details, we can click on Activate to conclude the activation procedure. Now we can see the success message that one product license has been successfully activated for the provided machine. Now we do have an option to view the license instantly here. We also have the option to download the license file from the download license button. The downloaded license would be in XML format. Now we are ready to apply it to the data domain. So we'll switch to the data domain, go to the administration, licenses, click on add license, and upload the license file that was just downloaded from the Software Licensing Central portal and click on Apply to have it applied on the data domain. And voila, it has been successfully added. That's how we will be applying the license manually using the traditional method. Now let's go through the second method of license activation, that is the in-product license activation. This new feature has been introduced in DDoS 8.1. For in-product license activation, the system needs to have connectivity to internet. Once connectivity is confirmed, then the license can be activated, downloaded, and applied to the system directly from the data domain itself. So here, we will go through the supported OS and the platform models. As we know, this feature has been newly introduced in the DDoS 8.1. So it does support 8.1 and later releases. And the platform model it supports currently are DD9910, DD9410, DD3300, and DD6400. Now, we will go over the demonstration of in-product license activation. For this method of license activation, we will log in directly to the Data Domain System Manager using sysadmin credentials. As you can see, this has 8.1 OS installed and the pop-up showcases about the new feature in product license activation, which has been newly introduced in this OS. Now we will close this pop-up and we'll go to the administration, licenses, click on add license, select download from Dell server. Here it says the license will be downloaded from the Dell portal. Click on download. You can see the license has been downloaded successfully. Then click apply button in the same pop-up to have it applied on the data domain directly. We can see the license has been applied successfully. Both the capacity and feature license have been reflected over here. So that's how we can directly have license activation done from the data domain itself from OS 8.1 and above for the supported platforms. This is called in-product license activation. And that concludes our video where we have seen both the methods of license activation. Thank you for joining today to learn all about the PowerProtect Data Domain License Activation.